Pretty. chin.
You know we gotta get the corners.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And make sure all the pieces are here. I only opened it one time. I can't imagine I've lost anything. Excuse me. I call this mishmash because this is all the stuff that doesn't have a straight edge or doesn't have a corner. This is in the middle of this mishmash. So let's do the edges. This blue, I guess, is near the bottom and the side. Okay, not that. Now we have these. These are the top corners. Mm-hmm. there's 25 pieces. I could possibly, if they're big like this, I could possibly do 50 pieces. But I think what happens is when the pieces start to get so teeny tiny, before I even get started, it stresses me out. Terrible. So, we'll see how this goes. Let me know. Oh my goodness, look. We got the frame. Oh. This is fun now. Yes. I want to do another puzzle now. How cute was that? That was totally fun, you guys. Now what do we do? Okay. was fun. Now what do we do? I should probably get these pretty nice coupons while we go out today. Remember, I cut out these coupons. Thank you. interesting. Probably bring this one out at Shark Week. Or do they have a Shark Week every June or July? I'll bring this out during Shark Week. This is one of my popular typing videos, I think. I kind of looked through all these books, but Big Cats of the World, Dinosaurs, Polar Regions, and Animals of Asia. Oh, there you have it. Also, a few more of these. The President, that was a good one. Let's look through. Since we did a puppy dog, let's do a cat book. Big Cats of the World. Big Cats of the World. This has grades 1, 2, 3, reading level 2. I could handle that. Let's see. Bendin' Books, written by Catherine Knight. It's kind of like a quiz book, right? You can quiz your friends or your parents. Big Cat, the African. African lion. The lion is the largest cat in Africa, and it lives in grassy areas called the savanna. Or do they call it savanna? Savanna, potato, potato. Lions live in groups called prides, and the males take care of the pride. If an enemy gets too close, they roar, and only the male lion has a thick mane. He sleeps about 20 hours a day and often hunts in groups at night. Oh, doesn't that sound like fun to sleep 20 hours a day? Oh, like, look, doesn't that look relaxing? Just draped over that wall. Oh my goodness. Are you guys awake still? Oh, not just relaxing. Oh, it's cute. When it's very hot, lions rest in the shade or near the water, and sometimes they nap on tree branches. I can't get over what this picture does for me. I probably need to make copies of this and pin this little picture up from room to room, and it will be my Baby lions are called cubs, and mother lions take care of their cubs for 2 years, and the cubs learn the rules of the pride and how to hunt. This graceful cat is the cheetah. It is one of the fastest animals in the world. It can sprint as fast as a car going 70 miles per hour on the highway. And cheetahs can zigzag as they run, so it's hard for even a quick gazelle to escape a cheetah. Interesting. A mother cheetah may have 2 or 3 cubs at a time. Before she hunts, she hides her cubs in the thick grass. And when the cubs are older, the mother teaches them how to hunt. At 1 year old, young cheetahs can take care of themselves, and they set out alone on the savannah. That's kind of interesting. I wonder why they haven't. Or maybe they do have a car made of gazelle, I'm not sure. Gazelles are so fast. I might do. Relax tonight, I'm thinking to myself, I might do, you might see this puzzle. I may do like a no talking one for children. I'll probably do a couple videos, little small ones for kids, one on the puzzle and one on this book. So, you might see a couple repeats. That's just coming to me as I'm doing it. How fun for kids, I think, if I could read this book to them. The leopard. Look at the handsome coat of this big cat. The leopard spots help it to blend in and hide in a forest or high grass. Leopards live Africa and in Southern Asia. Leopards are good climbers and they often perch in a tree looking for prey. They're looking for animals for their food. And leopards hunt many different animals. And a leopard is so strong, it can lift a heavy animal into a tree just by using its teeth. Oh my goodness. I think the two spookiest places for me to live would be, well, here in the States, Florida. I do not think I could live in Florida with all the alligators. Excuse me. Oh my goodness, I got a furball. I kind of did a half yawn. I got a furball in my throat. Excuse me. The two spookiest places. I would be so scared to live in Florida. In fact, we had friends of ours move to Florida. At the time, my husband was a realtor, and he sold their home here, sold the home, helped purchase their home, a new home for them in Florida. And then it was the alligators. They were so terrified. They moved back here to California. Excuse me. So it was real for them. Too many times they'd wake up and see an alligator too close to their house or right in their backyard. But yeah, that was something that was like a whirlwind of a year. They sold their home in California like in May, bought a home in Florida in June. Sell their home. We got like a commission off of selling their home in Florida, and then found them a new home back here in California in August. That was crazy, but that was a fun summer for us because my husband made a lot of commissions for us just on that one friend. But you know, I do not think I'd ever be able to live in Florida nor in Africa with all these men. Because I'm sure the animals are, they're just in one place, but who knows? I'd be thinking about them all the time. Excuse me. Anyways, interesting. Really a leopard. Its spots are hard to see because its coat is so dark. Black leopards are able to hide in the shadows of a jungle bush. A yellow leopard mother can give birth to both yellow and black cubs. Oh, I didn't know that. I learned something new today. Asian lion. They are safe from hunters, and these are Asian lions, which differ from African lions in several ways. They have lighter colored fur, and they hunt smaller prey, and the males and females live apart. Interesting. I have no clue. Striped coats that help them hide in tall grass. The Bengal tiger of India and South Central Asia is called the royal tiger. Males can weigh up to 600 pounds, and there are very few Bengal tigers left in the world. New laws help to protect this amazing animal. Interesting. I know that. A mother Bengal tiger can have 3 cubs at one time, and cubs stay with their mothers for 2 years and then go out on their own. And the Bengal tiger is so strong, it can hunt animals much bigger than its own, and it hunts deer, pigs, and buffalo. my goodness, my candle. Are you kidding me? Hold on here. So, did I do that by... Wait a minute. I had to get the wick out. I might have done this myself by swishing the candle around. The wax went up. But I do love this apple cinnamon. Oops. There we go. Oh, I love that sound of a crackling. Sorry, you guys. That's no fun. I think I swished the candle out myself. I need to be careful. Alright. Is a large cat that lives in high mountain areas. It has a thick, warm coat of fur and large padded feet, perfect for a cold, snowy home. Snow leopards are great hunters, and they can make 50-foot leaps to catch large birds and mammals of all sizes. Are you kidding me? 50 feet? That's a pretty big clip for a jump. The reason I'm saying that is because just a few days ago, I got a hose. Needed this little sprinkler hose from Amazon. In fact, you'll see it. You'll see it when I do my next Amazon haul. And it was 25 feet. And then when it got here, I realized, like, oh my goodness, I should have gotten a way bigger hose, like 25 feet. So I know right now off the top of my head, I know how far 25 feet is. Can jump double that size. That's amazing. But I think I just totally messed up. I should have measured properly before I ordered. Okay, so let's see here. Next, the clouded leopard. Also live in Asia, and they are smaller than snow leopards. They weigh 35 to 50 pounds, and clouded leopards live in forests. By 11 weeks old, the cubs are already excellent tree climbers. Have you ever seen the long teeth on pictures of saber-toothed tigers that lived long ago? Wow, the teeth of a clouded Siberian tiger. I think that's the tiger I'm most familiar with. I think. I'm not sure. The Siberian tiger of Northern Asia is the largest cat in the world, and it can weigh 700 pounds. More than three average men. It is a powerful and quick hunter. And there are not many of these beautiful tigers left in the world. Oh my goodness. The Siberian tiger likes to live alone in low mountain areas, and it hides in forests and high reeds near the rivers. large animals, like wild pigs, deer, and elk. And this tiger will even attack bears. It will carry a 300-pound animal and swim with it across the river. Oh my goodness. Lynx. The lynx is the largest wild cat. Kind of looks like a kitty cat, like a huge cat. That was kind of, but a huge. The lynx is the largest wild cat in Europe. It has tufts on its ears and a short tail. It lives hidden in dense forest areas. And it is a skilled tree climber and can swim across rivers. And the lynx can attack with a lightning fast sprint and leap as far as 16 feet. And when it walks, it keeps its claws pulled in so it does not leave clear tracks. Interesting. Lynx, and then here's a Canadian lynx. They almost look the same, almost. The coat of the Canadian lynx is thick and long. In the winter, the color is lighter, making the lynx hard to see against the snow. And the Canadian lynx is a quick hunter and it can catch birds right out of the air. And Canadian lynx cubs are cute balls of fluff born in the spring. Isn't that cute? Totally cute. Like, it looks like a bobcat. The bobcat of North America is sometimes called a red lynx. It has a sharp cry, and when it's in danger, it makes a sound like a cough. A bobcat is nocturnal and it hunts at night and sleeps during the day, and its favorite prey is a jackrabbit. That makes sense. The ocelot, O-C-E-L-O-T, ocelot. The ocelot of Central and South America is sometimes called a painted leopard, but it is not a leopard. It's a small wild cat that hunts at night. And ocelot cubs look and act just like kittens, and cubs raised by humans will purr like house cats. That is crazy. Oh my goodness. Pumas live in North and South America in cold mountains and hot deserts too. They may have tan coats, red or yellow-gray coats, and they weigh 75 to 240 pounds. The puma is a strong hunter and it can leap 25 feet. Pumas will travel far in search of food and sometimes as much as 25 miles in one night. Oh my goodness, that's a marathon, isn't it? Is a marathon 24 miles or 26? 24 or 26 miles. Okay, that's like, maybe it's 26 miles, I can't remember. North American puma cougar. pumas in North America are called cougars, mountain lions, or panthers. The cubs are born with spots, which they lose after 10 months. Huh. Cougars will hunt for small and large prey, and they eat mice, porcupines, birds, and fox. Sometimes cougars attack livestock like sheep, but most of the time, cougars stay away from farms and people. Huh. That's kind of scary. Every once in a while, in the valley, San Fernando Valley, morning news, well, every once in a while, it's like too often every once in a while, because Southern California people, they want to live up in the mountains, and, you know, they want to have this property in the hills. So what has happened is they've built more and more homes in the mountains and in the hills, which really is where all these wild animals kind of lived. So now they're building so close into the mountains and hills of the animals. Every week we see somebody in the valley whose house or swimming pool was had a bear in it, or bear cubs, or mountain lion, or fox. Kind of just too close for comfort. And in all honesty, it's kind of our fault. I don't blame the animals, because they're kind of like dislocated. Really. I'm amazed when I look at like an updated map of where they build new homes. It gets further and further and further up in the hills and up in the mountains of the valley. It's unbelievable. Interesting though. Cougar cubs are often born in a cave in the summer, and the mother protects them and keeps them clean by licking them. Oh, how cute. Okay. A cougar can act just like a really big pet cat, and it washes its face with a paw, and it rolls onto its back, and it eats like a house cat. But no matter how cute these cats may look, they can never be pets. These big cats are wild. I believe it. And that was fun. Yeah, you probably will see me do a little short video. From lions to lynx, learn more about some of the most beautiful and graceful animals to ever prowl the four corners of the earth. Bendon, distributed by Bendon Incorporated out of Zozo Prince. Zizo Prince. Do you think a gum chewing is funny because your mouth is so close to the mic? I mean, WTF, my brother. You're just not a gum. You just don't understand. Okay, from one of my typing videos. And next we have Smith Hunt. Hi, Angela. When you say $3 and change, what does that mean? Well, actually, it's $3 and change. It's usually like under 350. If it's over 350, I'll say not quite $4. Yeah, it's $3 and change, meaning it was somewhere between $3 and $3.49. It's over 350, I'll say not quite $4. All right. Thank you, Smith. And I try not to do that. I'll only do that if I don't have the receipt right in front of me. But most of the time, I prefer to have the receipt right there and give it exact information. Goran Q from my National Choir. And as much as I like the gum sounds, I love the cracker ones even more. Thank you. Thank you. You know what? There's my little Ritz crackers. And that's terrible. Ritz crackers are not healthy at all, you guys. But, I'm going to take a time out from my gum here. Listen to this. I have to agree. I love the crinkly little bag. And I love to put like a whole cracker in my mouth. I'm with you. I love that sound. But, so, I don't know. I don't know if I could really switch into doing that or maybe do it back and forth. So we'll see. Thank you, Goran. Shelly May writes, I totally drink the brine too. Oh, from the olive. The olives. Yeah, I call it juice, but I think you're right. Like pickles and olives, it's brine. Shelly, thank you for watching and for your comment. And Christian Rodriguez writes, thank you for trying something different. Oh, from the snoring, the manly man. Snoring and light breathing. You know what I'm thinking of doing next time? Tell me what you guys think of this. Are you awake still? I'm thinking of, as the manly man is sleeping and snoring and heavy breathing, I don't know if I could do it with a straight face. I was thinking of sitting really close by in a chair and saying, breathe in, breathe out, and making like a role play, like I'm a sleep therapist. And talking real calm. And say, now welcome to our sleep session. Breathe in. Breathe out. And then you would hear the manly man in the background or foreground. I'm not sure if you would hear me in the background or foreground. But that's a thought that came to me. But I kind of have a hunch I'd be laughing. That's kind of like a project on my mind. Thank you, Christian, for watching and your comment. And Crystal Brown writes from my Diabolo French soda that I was disappointed in. I could be wrong, but I think anything that ends with T-O-L is a type of sugar like mannitol, sorbitol, xylitol. And I wish I could like those kind of drinks. Stevia, because I refuse to drink anything else, artificial sweeteners. But it leaves an awful aftertaste in my mouth for some reason. Crystal, you might be absolutely right, because there was kind of a funny taste to that drink. You might be right. I'm trying to cut down on my soda intake, but I crave the carbonation so much. Can't have caffeine. So when I get a soda craving, I've been putting a splash or two of either grenadine or grape juice in club soda. It isn't the best, but it helps. Crystal, get a pen and paper. I have the healthiest carbonated drink for you. Kombucha. You can get it at Walmart or Target in the refrigerated section, like $3.50 a bottle. That is so highly carbonated, and it's a healthy drink. And depending on how much carbonation you want, I get like the strawberry or the cranberry kiwi. That has a huge carbonated punch. You can get like something flat, like a mango or a hibiscus or a lavender. It doesn't seem to have as big of a carbonated punch. But thank goodness for those drinks. They're like a probiotic. They have like live enzymes and live cultures to help. It's like a fermented drink. Do you know, those drinks saved my life. I was able to kick my Diet Coke addiction by switching to kombucha. It's even way better carbonated than Diet Coke. So don't forget kombucha, and you can search my channel for, I think I've done a couple kombucha videos. Thank you, Crystal. I really appreciate having you on board. Rachel St. Clair writes that I think I'll pass on this drink also, but I too like the packaging. Thank you, doll. I love your videos. Oh, Rachel, thank you. Again, from the French soda pop. Yeah, isn't that crazy? That was like an impulse. The can was so pretty. Terrible. Oh, Bill Coffin. What does he write? You're living dangerously by keeping those crackers and that gum on the same counter. Oh my goodness. One of these days you might forget yourself and need a rich cracker while chewing gum, and we will get one of the greatest blooper reels of all time. That is so funny. That could be true, and that's terrible how I'm incorporating the rich crackers, but you guys have to let me know what you think. But I do like the Ritz crackers. Bill, that's funny. Thank you for your support, Bill. I appreciate you watching my videos. You know what I have almost done? It's worse. When I have my little candle sitting here, I've had an impulse to grab the candle instead of my coffee cup. Now that would really be a video blooper. Kelly McLeland, right? Great job on the rambling and the hair brushing. Thank you, Kelly. And thank you for watching and for commenting. Lauren Herman. Lauren, you've been watching me a long time. Thank you. Oh, Anja. I adore you. And do you think I'll ever try another role play? Maybe a medical role play? Some sort. You have a lot of great tools and knowledge to make a potentially great medical role play. Please consider it. As I always thank you for another lovely video. Lauren, I could, in my mind, I could do it easier now. Because I would just invite you guys in. So I will keep that in the back of my mind. And if it's not a medical role play, it would be like a grocery or a health food store role play. And I would be the worker in that health food store. And you guys would be coming in shopping, buying a health supplement.
I thought of that one.
Then Camilla Moda writes, so ASMR, from my reading The Classifieds the other day. Thank you, Camilla. And Lauren again writes, please do another personal ad. Oh my goodness, remember the personal ads from the Globe? That is hysterical. I need to do that. You're right. Those are good, Lauren. Thank you. Those are one of my most favorite videos of yours. Plus, I love hearing you laugh and have a good time. I do too, but then it's like a catch 22 because I love laughing. But that's not nice to laugh because those are real people. And that's a real ad. And I'm laughing at them and I feel bad about that. I feel bad. But on the other hand, I love to laugh. Okay. Next, Antoine Lewis writes from my bread buyer paper. Yeast is really good for you, just like many other fungus. And read more before you speak, buyer beware. Antoine, it did not say nutritional yeast. FYI, I know about nutritional yeast. There were so many awful ingredients, sugar being at the top of the list. I doubt very seriously they added the nutritional yeast. I know about yeast. You know, and I'm trying to figure out why are they even mentioning yeast. And anyways, yeah, we disagree there, Antoine. Sorry about that. Next. Oh, and Dirta responds to Antoine. Well, she's not wrong. I've never seen a healthy bread with those ingredients first. And if I were to walk into some place expecting wheat bread, the bread would make me ill. It's a good message to read ingredients. Yes. Yes. We just need to read ingredients, you guys. I'm just as guilty as the next person. But thank you both for your comment and for watching. Nightmare EX writes, I love how you give facts while you're eating. Thank you, Nightmare. And sometimes it's a nightmare what the facts are of what we're eating. Are you guys even awake still? And next, Antoine Lewis again writes from the bread, or are we bread? Health doesn't always mean like healthy. It means a lot of other things. Yes, you're right, but when it's in the healthy bread section, you know, you're led to believe it might be like a bait and switch, but I don't even get me started again with that Oro wheat bread. I'm thoroughly disgusted with them. Brita Lane, gum, people. But do whatever you like. What does that mean? Camp gum, people. Brita, thank you, Brita. Peaceful wishes from the Oro wheat bread. Great video. Thanks for reminding us to look for hidden sugars as our family is trying to limit our intake of sugar as well. Yes. And if you go back to that video in the description box below, scroll down and there's a link to spooky things in a bunch of so-called breads, healthy breads and regular breads. You guys will freak out. All the stuff they put in. Anyways, don't get me started. Thank you, Peaceful. T-Vlogs writes, thank you, I love these videos from my classified. Yes, I'm going to do more classified. Thank you, T-Vlog. And Ethan Films writes, happy face, from my unboxing the Birch Box, the magic inside Birch Box. This little guy, I checked out his website, his YouTube channel. He's a young, possibly middle school, possibly junior high. Kind of a cute little channel. And he's had several different attempts at making the channels. For a while there, he was making magic videos. So that's maybe why he saw my magic, my unboxing, because it was called The Magic Inside Birchbox. But he's got kind of a cute little channel if you want to check him out. All one word, Ethan, you know, the name Ethan, E-T-H-A-N, Films, all one word, F-I-L-M-S. And next, Jose Brandes writes, woohoo, a birthday shout out from my favorite ASMR artist made my day. And this is Creeping Menace, by the way. Thank you for reminding me. I had wondered what happened to you, but you're right. You reminded me before that that's who you are. And thank you for commenting and for your support, Jose. I really appreciate you. Are you guys awake still? Well, I've got homework to do. We're going to have a new candle for next time. Do I get a new candle? I need to get a better gum. You know what happened? This is so yummy. And then I tried this, and this is just not near as yummy. And it's a big disappointment. So, in fact, I might as well put this off. Care of my fingernails, and every time I'm in Sally's Beauty, I totally forget. So I'm going to be in Target today, and what happens is I need to have a filing, an emery board, in every area of my house where I'm at, because you know what happens? If I have like a I'll just rip. Instead of getting the nail file and nicely filing the problem fingernail, I'll just rip it right off, and that's terrible. But if I have the nail file right there, I'll take care of it properly, and that's what I need to do to fix that problem. It's terrible sometimes to be so lazy to. That's good enough for government work. I'm gonna get new. And what else? Oh, do you see this? Can you see that terrible thumb? Remember I've told you about omega-3 supplements and how it's like a skin and brain lubricant, like it's a healthy fat. For your brain and a healthy fat for your joints and your skin. Well, we were out of omega-3 for a few days again. I get so upset at myself when we run out of stuff. It's usually a financial issue of why I can't get something right away. It's very frustrating. But, so anyway. This is like a typical example. After, I hardly ever have like terribly brittle fingernails or like terribly raw, dry, ripped cuticles like that. Hardly ever, because I'm pretty regular, religiously. Really, the only lotion I use, if I have to use a topical lotion, is this Aveeno. And these little ingredients, but for some reason, Aveeno seems to be the safest in my mind. But maybe someday we need to talk about the ingredients in there. I see a few words that are pretty spooky, possibly. Anyway, are you guys awake still? This was fun. We got a lot of fun, relaxing time together tonight. We did a puzzle. We got to do the Big Cats of the World book. I got to chew some gum. Brushing. Had fun. Had a good time. This was a good start for me. I'm glad I started out with the Thin Mint gum. Love this. Mmm.